Abraham's first appearance in public. Now, Abraham, at the command of Yahuwah, was ordered by the angel Gabriel to follow Nimrod to Babylon. He objected that he was in no wise equipped to undertake a campaign against the king, but Gabriel calmed him with the words, "Thou needest no provision for the way, no horse to ride upon, no warriors to carry on war with Nimrod, no chariots nor riders. Do thou but sit thyself upon my shoulder, and I shall bear thee to Babylon." Abraham did as he was bidden, and in the twinkling of an eye, he found himself before the gates of the city of Babylon. At the behest of the angel, he entered the city, and he called unto the dwellers therein with a loud voice, "The Eternal, he is the one only God, and there is none beside. He is the God of the heavens and the God of the gods, and the God of Nimrod. Acknowledge this as the truth, all ye men, women, and children. Acknowledge also that I am Abraham, his servant, the trusted steward of his house." Abraham met his parents in Babylon, and also he saw the angel Gabriel, who bade him proclaim the true faith to his father and his mother. Therefore Abraham spake to them and said, "Ye serve a man of your own kind, and you pay worship to an image of Nimrod. Know ye not that it has a mouth, but it speaks not, an eye, but it sees not, an ear, but it hears not, nor does it walk upon its feet, and there is no profit in it, either unto itself or unto others." When Terah heard these words, he persuaded Abraham to follow him into the house, where his son told him all that had happened, how in one day he had completed a 40 days' journey. Terah thereupon went to Nimrod and reported to him that his son Abraham had suddenly appeared in Babylon. The king sent for Abraham, and he came before him with his father. Abraham passed the magnates and the dignitaries until he reached the royal throne, upon which he seized hold, shaking it and crying out with a loud voice, "O Nimrod, thou contemptible wretch, that deniest the essence of faith, that deniest the living and immutable God, and Abraham his servant, the trusted steward of his house, acknowledge him and repeat after me the words, 'The Eternal is Yahuwah, the only one, and there is none beside. He is incorporeal, living, ever existing. He slumbers not and sleeps not, who hath created the world that men might believe in him, and confess also concerning me, and say that I am the servant of Yahuwah and the trusted steward of his house.'" While Abraham proclaimed this with a loud voice, the idols fell upon their faces, and with them also King Nimrod, for a space of 2 hours and a half. The king lay lifeless, and when his soul returned upon him, he spoke and said, "Is it thy voice, O Abraham, or the voice of thy God?" And Abraham answered and said, "This voice is the voice of the least of all creatures called into existence by God." Thereupon Nimrod said, "Verily, the God of Abraham is a great and powerful God, the King of all kings." And he commanded Terah to take his son and remove him and return again unto his own city. And father and son did as the king had ordered.